Manifesting a positive, great day. I know that I'm gonna enjoy it because I love stuff like that. I mean, one of the girls in my class was a bit anxious yesterday because she doesn't like dead bodies. But we're gonna support her. We're gonna help her out. She'll be fine. And I've seen dead bodies before. Anxious at all. I'm pretty excited. Well, I don't wish anyone to die, but you know, it's part of life. People do die. I hope I'm not gonna be delayed with this traffic because I definitely don't wanna be late. You know, when you're really excited about something, you wake up early, you prepare, you leave the house early, and then the traffic gets jealous. It delays you. It's not fair. I mean, I don't like it. I've been manifesting a positive day because I wanted this day to be as exciting and stress-free as possible. But hey, things happen. Because this traffic, it's so slow. Like, I'm moving at 3 miles an hour. Yeah, I know my lecturer will understand, but you just want to get there on time. I don't like being late. But I do get late sometimes. So things doesn't always happen the way we want. I do get some days where everything is just going wrong and you're just like, what is going on? And I just hope it's not going to be one of those days. Fingers crossed. This is where it's going down. This is the building that we're gonna be in today. So I'm gonna get in. I hope I'll be able to show you guys what we're gonna do. Dissecting a body. It was really fun and it was really awesome, guys. I really enjoyed it. So much credit is given to the people who donated their body because they really didn't have to, guys. It's it gives such a very good opportunity for us to learn. Unfortunately, guys, I wasn't allowed to take any pictures or any photos because there are rules that we still have to follow. I know the people are dead already, but we still have to treat them with dignity, respect, and all that aspect. So we were not allowed to take any videos or pictures at all. I really wanted to take a picture of the room just to show you guys how the room looks like, but it was literally a no phone area, so I'm really, really sorry I didn't get to show you, but I'm sure you understand, guys. One of my classmates, she was really, really scared. She was really, really anxious about seeing a dead body, but we were all very supportive, and the lecturers were really, really good as well. They introduced the bodies to her with TLC slowly, you know, so that she just doesn't go in and bam, there you go, the dead body's right there. And she was pretty fine in the end. So if you're one of those people who are really anxious, don't be shy to tell your lecturers. I'm pretty sure they'll be supportive. They'll introduce the body to you slowly and slowly. I feel like I learned so much today, and I feel like it's gonna stick in my brain more because I get to see exactly where the heart is, exactly where the aorta goes, where the veins are, where the nerves, the spinal cord, the brain. We covered so much this morning, and you know, it's one thing when you're looking at it from a textbook, but when you're actually seeing it in real, it makes more sense. So it was really, really a helpful session today. We get an opportunity to actually touch the parts, you know, because of course you're wearing gloves. Although the dead body didn't have the intestines in the abdominal because they took it off for whatever reason, I would think that it wouldn't be wise to keep the intestines. So we would really, really understand. Otherwise, every other organ was still there. And I am forever grateful for the patient who decided to donate their body to us. I think it's really, really amazing. I think it's really, really awesome. And I think she really thought about helping others through us because we're going to be educated so we can help others out there. So the session was 3 hours this morning and it's lunchtime at the minute. So my classmates will be going back later on in the lecture theatre and they're going to be discussing about what we've learned, what could be done better, a little bit of reflection. Like I always say, guys, we're all going to be reflective practitioner. But unfortunately, I have to leave early because I have an occupational health appointment. So I'm going to go attend to that because I do need those jabs to stay on the course. And also, guys, we had an opportunity to see other organs in the room, not specifically from the dead body, but one of those that were kept in a form of a glass that had liquid in it. I don't know what liquid it was, but I guess it's to protect it and keep it moist. So we had an opportunity to be shown, and we saw what a brain with an aneurysm looks like and some of the diseased organs, what they really look like in actual reality, because they were all real organs from dead bodies. So it was really, really amazing and very, very useful. But it was pretty, pretty amazing. I really, really enjoyed. I'm gonna end this video right now because I don't want to be late for my occupational health appointment. And keep tuned in, guys. If you haven't already, don't forget to smash that subscribe button and become part of our team. Also like you to follow me on Instagram, which is right here. And if you do follow me, don't be shy to message me your comments, your questions, or what you think about this video. Don't forget that I love you, and I hope to see you again in my next video. Bye-bye.